Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Dragon Quest II. I am Rufal, playing this game for you. Woo! Well, Charlock Castle certainly looks as intimidating as we remember, but is it? No, I'd have to say Charlock Castle has seen better days. But never mind that. Let's make our way deeper in. Now, I do appreciate the nostalgia hit that the music is providing. Of course, since Dragon Quest 1 is on the same cartridge as this game, it's not too difficult for them to get a hold of the music. These mummy men are probably the most dangerous thing we're going to run into down here. They hit that hard. Let's get the Gorgon heads out of the way and proceed to pummel the mummies. Ow! Please leave her alone. Yeesh. Oh, I didn't quite mention it in such a way as to make it clear, but the only purpose for the token of Roto was getting the helmet of Roto. It wasn't necessary to get the shield, just the helmet. Because the helmet was guarded by some jerk. Let's make our way deeper in. Oh, good gosh. I put these guys to sleep, but the undead don't like to go to sleep. Usually they like to hallucinate, though. Doesn't necessarily mean a lot. Yes, please keep attacking him. That would so make my day. Boy, even Maria can hit those mummy men appreciably. They sacrificed all their defense for additional attack power. It worked. These Gorgon heads have a lot of defense going for them, so Ken and Maria really can't hit them appreciably at all. Fortunately, they don't have a lot of hit points going for them. That's harsh. The saber wolves are the other majorly dangerous thing down here. They hit about as hard as the mummy men, but they also hit twice. Big difference, of course, is that the mummy men usually come in packs large enough to get somebody killed. Yeesh. Alright, now's where we have an option of where to go. We can take these stairs or we can run around down to that other stairway. Ultimately, they both lead to the same place. just this stairway is going to involve a couple more rooms. But if we had taken the other stairwell, we would have come up on those stairs over there in the corner. Regardless, let's come this way. Blast 'em! Yay! More yay! Eight? Excellent! Now Kane can get us out of here. It's gonna be awfully nice to not have to walk. And here we have most puzzling thing egg in the entire dungeon. Why did our ancestor just put the Sword of Roto back in this box? We may never know. But there is something interesting about the sword in this game. That's that our second prince can actually equip the thing, which makes it slightly more useful. Yes, only slightly. There's still more powerful weapons in the game that that guy can equip. Oh well. At least it'll see more use. Or, use. But never mind that. There's more treasure here. We just have to make the trip. Oh boy. Oh! Ow! Defend, darling. The boys should be able to handle it. Boy, everybody wants to take a bite out of Maria. I mean, I do too, just not in that way. She might need more hit points than that. We'll worry about that later. Alright! Down here on the bottom floor, there's... I don't think there's any encounters to speak of. But there is treasure! But let's go over here and speak with not the Dragon King. Except totally the Dragon King. Hello, sir! Ah, so you have come, Rufo. I am the great-grandson of the King Dragon, the King of Kings. I heard recently that a person called Hargon has grown to an enormous size. It also seems that his face has become horribly grotesque. Indeed, that is unpleasant. You don't seem open-minded, so I feel awkward asking you something. If you will defeat Hargon, I can tell you something good, and you can take my place. What do you say? He actually makes a good offer when you think about it. And saying no to him is going to lock out your ability to get the advice that he's offering. So, let's say yes and get said advice. Ho-ho, come forward. Collect the 5 crests. If you do that, I hear you will receive the protection of the spirits. It seems there is a small island in the sea, south of a town long ago called Mercado. First of all, go there. If you collect the crests and receive the power of the spirit, you can defeat Hargon. Well, let's see if he'll give us the opportunity to say no, and then we can see that option. And he will! Fascinating. That is disturbing. You are a surprisingly stupid person. I have nothing more to say. Get out of here. Yeah, if you've gotten that message, then, then he'll talk about Hargon, and that is the end of the conversation. Yeah, you only get the opportunity to say yes once, because if you say no, then you don't get to try again. Oh well. Using as that was, let's see if we can brave the barriers and gather treasure. Half-step costs 7 hit points. Survived! And find ourselves the world map! We have an actual map to use! It's great! And some steel armor! Sail fodder! Woo! Alright, now that we have looted the place, let's get out of here! And if feeling really paranoid, then, return would be applicable. I'm not feeling that paranoid. Let's explore these doors that require the golden key. What do we have up here? Fairy water? Oh, it's a sewing shop. I would love the Dew's yarn! Aww. Awesome! Thank you for the info! Thank you for making us feel welcome. Hey you! Have some stuff to sell! I don't need the steel sword anymore! I don't want to buy stuff, I'm still wanting to sell stuff. Let's see... I have no need for this armor. Thank you, sir. Hey, you! Get back to work! You're a king! Kings don't retire! Not without an heir, at least. Ugh. Silly man. We'll actually use the inn, because it's a little faster than making use of the guy who restores your magic. Us fiddling around in the menus, after all. At the, The Dragon King's grandson had mentioned had mentioned something on an island south of where Mercado used to be. Mercado, of course, is synonymous with Cantlin. Well, there does appear to be an island down there. Let's check it out. Make an attempt to preserve my magic points for it. Why would you go before Maria now? Strictly to annoy me. It's Kane and Maria working together can take down a sea slug. Well, everything just wants my attention. Fly off! Sadly, the lands of Alufgard don't really have much in them in this game. Not that they had much in them in 8-bit, for that matter, but, yeah. Specifically, the only things to be found are Ratatomb, Charlock Castle, and the shrine with the jerk who gave us the helmet of Roto. You've no business here. Clear off. Aha! Oh, sir! Okay. I have! Okay. Well, interesting. Oh, we did come for that crest. I'm a little concerned that the echoing flute didn't sound. Interesting. Especially since the star crest is supposed to be here. If the crest isn't here, then, what is here? Painful death! Get him, Kane! Ow! You're supposed to do that before Maria got mauled. Well, in theory, that's what we carry around these herbs for. Alright. Keep continuing this way to progress through the maze. Oh, punk! Get him! Alright! That's scary. you to defend for a moment. Yeah, just let the top guy deal with it. This way. Clear off, punk! Right. Don't! Well, that told me two things about these death gods. First off, they don't always attack twice. And second, they don't focus fire a target. There are enemies that do that, after all. Thank you for going first. Get it, Kane! Oh. Well done, sir. Yay. Aw. Kinda hoping for a new spell. But no matter. Let's come in here. And make our way to a box. The tower. In order to loot it, we want to ignore that stairway we just passed by, and the stairway that was just to the left of it. Both of those stairways would lead to dead ends. Yay! If I need to do inventory management, that's the first thing that's gonna go. This stairway will lead us to treasure. Eventually. Nothing to the north, so back down we go. It's been a long time since I've seen ants. Mm. like that, punk! Yay! Ow! Ow! Oh boy. Ugh. Well, pardon me while I go and fix that, and we'll get back to making our way up the tower. One moment. Alright. Back at the tower, and still fighting many a thing. For those wondering, the cost for reviving a person is 20 times their level. So Maria, being level 9, required cost 180 gold pieces to revive. Which isn't too bad, but there's nothing more to be found up those stairs. And Kane had gained a level on the way back. So, let's make our way up these stairs. Let's see here. Third floor. Let's see. These stairs lead to loot. The other way leads to a dead end. Come down here. And take more treasure. Undead men. Sounds strangely redundant, but whatever. Well, I can't hit Roof for anything, but that doesn't mean anything. He's armored out the wazoo. Yes, how dangerous an enemy is revolves around how hard it can hit Kane and Maria. Go figure. So far, no indication about them. Let's see. Let's come this way. The dragonflies! Get him! Yay! Ah, there's our treasure chest. Well, let's trip for nuts. Let's see. Indications are that there's actually another box along in here, but I have a hard time saying where that is. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4. No, I got them all. Alright then. hard time counting just because of that, having to leave. Oh, punks! Yay! We don't want that stairway, because we want this one. That. Open the door. Kill off some gorgons. Get the heads thereof. Well, that worked out. See if I can just put these guys to sleep. Not so much! Good to know, good to know. This could hurt. Fortunately, they were merciful. Kane, why did you go first? I mean, outside of just to annoy me. That dragonfly had gotten to attack. I was gonna be really upset with you, Kane. Howdy-ho! Poor ants! That punk. Yay. Woo. Eat. Turn spell for reducing enemy defense and hey you. Hey old man. These ants in slightly different fashion. Ow!
Hmm.
Well, that hurt. Dang, that magic armor of yours seems terrible. Please tell me that was a good reason why I traded the evasion clothes for it. Assumptions, that's what. Okay. Ah! Right. So he went down this one. Oh, there he is. Kill an ant, right? Very good. Little jerk. Yeesh. I see. That worked out. Wait up, old man. Oh, there he is. Alrighty, what we got here? We have a trap! It's a little bit disconcerting that they're in separate groups like that. Mostly because there is a formation of these gremlins that, can softlock the game. In fact, this might be it. So, basically it all revolves around, here's group one, here's group two. This is not group three, this is group four. So, mostly means I'll want to kill that one first. That should have averted any soft block possibility. I suppose, in a way, it's more of a hard lock. But, you know, now that these guys are asleep, this should go easily. Goodbye, sir. Ooh, rot. Hooray! So we have our crest. So, let's get out of here, and then next time, we'll do other things. We'll see you then. Later.